हेलो क्लास, टुडे आवर टॉपिक इज डबल फर्टिलाइजेशन एंड दिस टॉपिक इज फ्रॉम सेक्सुअल रिप्रोडक्शन इन फ्लावरिंग प्लांट. ओके, सो टुडे वी विल अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज मीन बाय डबल फर्टिलाइजेशन एंड हाउ इट टेक्स प्लेस इन एंजियोस्पर्म. और आई कैन से दिस इज अ कैरेक्टरिस्टिक फीचर ऑफ एंजियोस्पर्म. सो अ डबल फर्टिलाइजेशन आई कैन सी इन एंजियोस्पर्म. सो बिफोर दैट वी नीड टू लर्न अबाउट द स्ट्रक्चर ऑफ ओव्यूल, दैट इज एम्ब्रियो सैक. So here we have the micropylar end and these are the integument and this one is termed as the chalazal end. Now at the micropylar end basically I have a two cell which is termed as synergid. So this is two synergid cells which is present at the micropylar end. Also I have one cell which is known as the egg. So total three cells are present at the micropylar end. We'll draw the nucleus. Whereas at the chalazal end, I am having again three cells and these three cells are termed as antipodal cell. These are antipodal cell. So we have synergid, we have egg and we have the antipodal cell. Now at this position, at the central position, I am having two polar nuclei. I am having two polar nuclei and this entire is going to be termed as what? This entire is going to be termed as central cell. So this is polar nuclei and this entire cell, which is a very large, is termed as central cell. So basically I have synergid, egg, antipodal cell and central cell. Now if I see this cell, how many cell I am having? 1, 2, 3. 3 at the micropylar, 1, 2, 3 at the chalazal and 1 at the center. So that means total I am having 7 cell. So embryo sac is 7 cell structure. Apart from that, we need to count the nuclei. So here I am having 3 nuclei at the micropylar end, 3 at the antipodal end and 2 in the central cell. So total 8. So it's a 7 celled 8 nucleated structure. So embryo sac is 7 celled 8 nucleated structure. Now as we said double fertilization, so that means there will be a 2 time fertilization. So here we are having two male gamete. In case of angiosperm, we have the two male gamete. Okay, we know that male gamete will be carried by the pollen tube. So pollen tube is going to carry the male gamete. So we have the pollen tube and this pollen tube is going to carry the male gamete. So this is pollen tube and these are male gamete. So this pollen tube is going to carry the male gamete. Now question is, from where this pollen tube will enter into the embryo sac? Generally it enter from micropylar end. Generally in number of cases it enter through micropylar end. Whereas we have two more option, that is one is the integument and the last one we have the chalazal. So if the pollen tube enter embryo sac through micropylar end, such type of pollen tube entering is known as, such phenomena is known as porogamy. Whereas when the pollen tube enter embryo sac through integument, it is known as, yes, so it is going to be termed as, so it is termed as mesogamy. And when the pollen tube enter through chalazal end, it is termed as chalazogamy. So generally what I said, pollen tube is going to enter the embryo sac through micropylar end. It is termed as porogamy. Whereas there are certain cases where we had seen that this pollen tube will enter from or is entering from the integument as well as from the chalazal end. So in case of cucurbita, this pollen tube enter from or enter through integument. Whereas in case of casuarina, pollen tube enter through chalazal end, hence it is known as the chalazogamy. Now my pollen tube has entered. Now I am ready with the pollen tube. This pollen tube is containing two male gametes. Now if I will see at the synergid, here I am having the filiform apparatus. Now what filiform apparatus do? So generally this filiform apparatus attract pollen tube, that is towards egg cell. So here the filiform apparatus is going to attract the pollen tube towards the egg cell. Now but before that, this pollen tube will come in contact with the synergid. So the moment this pollen tube come in contact with this synergid, so it will come in contact, pollen tube come in contact with the cytoplasm of one of the synergid. So here this pollen tube will come in contact with the cytoplasm of one of the synergid. Now from here it is going to absorb the water. After absorbing water, the pollen, the tip of the pollen tube is going to burst and it is going to release the two gametes. So here the gametes are going to be released in the synergid, in the cytoplasm of synergid. So hence one synergid will be destroyed over here. Okay, now I am having the two gamete right now over here. So one gamete will fuse with the egg and other will fuse with the polar nucleus. So we need to check. So one male gamete fuses with the egg cell and it will give me zygote. So here one male gamete fuses with the egg cell will give me the zygote. So we'll write the haploid or diploid. So here male gamete is haploid. Haploid male gamete fuses with the haploid egg cell to give me the diploid zygote. Obviously here the haploid set and egg is also having the haploid set. So both are going to combine and I'll be having the diploid set of zygote. I'm left with the one more male gamete. So this male gamete is going to combine with the polar nuclei. Now this time it's going to be polar nuclei. So here it's going to combine with the polar nuclei and will give me primary endosperm nucleus. That is, it is going to give me primary endosperm nucleus. Now here again male gamete is haploid. Now this time polar nuclei, two set of nuclei, that means it's a diploid. So here it's going to be diploid and hence I'll be having a triploid structure known as the primary endosperm nucleus. Okay, so in first case male gamete fuses with the egg cell or also known as the oosphere, and hence it will give me zygote, which is a diploid. Similarly, other male gamete will fuse with the polar nuclei, which is a diploid, will give me the triploid primary endosperm nucleus. Now, this type of fusion where male gamete is fusing with the egg, this is known as syngamy. seen gamete. Whereas the second type, where the male gamete is fusing with the polar nuclei, it is giving me primary endosperm nucleus. That means your three nuclei are fusing. So such type of fusion is known as triple fusion. So here I am having one as a syngamy and second as a triple fusion. So what is double fertilization? Double fertilization is nothing but a process of syngamy and triple fusion. So what is double fertilization? It is nothing but the process of fusion, syngamy and triple fusion. Process of syngamy and triple fusion. Now, what will be the product of zygote? What after zygote I am going to get? Or primary endosperm nucleus. So here, after zygote, this zygote will get converted into the embryo. And here, this primary endosperm nucleus will do the formation of endosperm. So here I am having the embryo and endosperm. Okay, now this special type of fertilization was discovered by S.G. Nawashin. First time he observed this type of phenomena or process in Lilium martagon and Fritillaria tenella. It's a common type of lily species which we get in the European countries, and this is a marine species. So in these two plants, S.G. Nawashin first time discovered this type of phenomena, that is double fertilization, in year 1898. Now, as we said here, male gamete. See, this male gamete is present in the pollen tube. Now, this male gamete has to be transferred to the egg cell or polar nuclei. So, that means this male gamete is what? This male gamete is non-motile. So, here this male gamete is non-motile. That is the reason why it is carried with the help of pollen tube. So, when non-motile gametes are transferred or transported with the help of pollen tube to the egg cell, where to the egg cell. Such type of process is known as siphonogamy. So it is known as siphonogamy. Okay, so if you have any doubt related to this topic, you can put your post or question in comment box. Okay, thanks, bye.